Good evening and welcome to Horizon. I'm Ted Simons. On Friday, the Secretary of State's office notified the governor that the Citizens for a Better Arizona Committee had filed enough valid signatures to force a recall election of State Senator Russell Pearce. Here to tell us what happens next is State Election Director Amy Bjelland. Good to have you here. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Now, he has to be officially notified of all this, correct?
Correct.
And has he been notified?
Yes. Our office was able to do that on Friday after we completed our certification and notified the governor.
Okay. Now, he has, what, like 5 days or something to respond?
He has 5 business days, and that'll end this Friday. He has until then to either decide to resign or remain in office.
And I think most folks think he's going to remain in office, but does he have to make this an official response, or just basically say...
An act of resigning would have to be done officially, and under the statutes, it would have to be done in writing.
Okay. Let's say that if he doesn't resign, does that mean he has to do anything else, or is he an automatic candidate?
Well, he'll be an automatic candidate. Under the law, he's allowed, as the candidate who's subject to the recall, to file a defensive statement with our office that would appear on the ballot.
Okay. So, oh, really?
Yes.
Interesting. Well, let's talk about the ballot in a second here.
Okay.
So when he says, I'm not resigning, he does so by way of a statement as to why he's not resigning.
Correct. And actually, it's up to him. He does have discretion. If he chooses not to resign, he doesn't have to file a defensive statement, but if he does want to file that, he has the 10 days to do so.
All right. What happens in the unlikely case that he should resign? Then what happens?
If he chooses to resign, there's no need for a recall. The office would be considered vacant under our state law, and it would be filled according to our state law, which in the legislative vacancy arena means that the precinct committeeman in his district would meet, nominate 3 people to fill the vacancy, and the Board of Supervisors would complete the appointment.
So it's similar to what we've seen before when there are vacancies at the state legislature.
That's right.
Now, he has a certain amount of time, 10 days, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to know exactly starting when, to challenge these signatures, correct?
Correct.
Now, when does that start?
It's actually 10 days from when Maricopa County certified, and that was last Friday, and so there are 10 days, the 10 days to challenge these signatures, and it could be Senator Pierce's camp, it could be anybody, any elector has the authority to challenge, but it's 10 days, so it should be July 18th, the last day to file that challenge.
And we'd get a Superior Court judgment on that particular challenge, and then, what, all sides, whoever feels wrong, they can appeal for what, how long?
They have another 10 days to appeal to the Supreme Court.
Wow, there's so many dates in here. We're going to throw some more out here. The governor has to call an election. When, 15 days she has to go? When did that start? When did the clock start?
That started the day after we notified her on Friday. And so she has until July 23rd to call the election.
Now, and that election would occur when?
Based on our timeline, it would be November 8th. That's the first consolidated election date that's 90 days or more out from when she's going to have to call the election.
So with that in mind, and let's just say that, you know, Pierce does not resign, she goes ahead and calls the election.
Mm-hmm.
What about candidates? How many signatures are needed, and how many folks can run?
Okay, well, this is for Legislative District 18, and they'll need 621 signatures, any candidate who wants to run for office. And it's based on the total number of votes cast for that seat at the last election.
Mm.
Anybody can run as long as they qualify to fill that seat, so they would also have to be a qualified voter from the district. And there's no need to specify your party affiliation. Anybody can run without regard to what party they are.
So if 50 people can manage to get 621 signatures, qualified signatures, you could have 50 people on the ballot.
That's possible, yeah.
With no party affiliation. No one knows who they are.
Correct. It's like the Wild West.
Like the Wild West, indeed. And they 621 again. And what happens if, you know, he files, but he doesn't think he filed? How many court challenge? What kind of challenge process is there?
Well, they would be filing between August 10th and September 9th, based on the November 8th election. And after August or September 9th, there would be a 10-day challenge period. And if there were that many candidates, it could be a little confusing, but probably a court would consolidate all of those into one matter.
Because I could see where one candidate would think, if there are too many of these other candidates, either are like me or not enough like me, or something, I don't necessarily want him on the ballot. I'm going to go ahead and challenge. That could happen.
Yeah, it could happen. It could.
And they have how long to get these 621 signatures?
They have until September 9th. They can start filing their petitions with our office on August 10th.
So that's a month.
Yeah.
That's why it's so little, 621 signatures, right? I mean,
well, yeah. It's actually 621 is more than you would file for a legislative seat in this district normally, but it is just a different, it's based on a different calculation.
Interesting. Yeah. All right, we talked about the fact that Senator Pearce has a chance to respond or make a statement of some kind. That will appear on the ballot.
Correct. That will appear on the ballot. The grounds for recall that the Citizens for a Better Arizona have listed on their application and on their petitions, that will appear at the top of the ballot. And then any statement that Senator Pearce files would appear on the ballot as well. And then below that would be the candidates, including Senator Pearce.
So basically, here's why this is happening. Here's the response as to the original allegations or whatever. And then everyone and their brother could be running below.
It's possible, yes.
It's possible, huh?
Yeah.
All right, so everything's kind of happening then. The wheels are in motion, and we just wait and see what gives.
Yeah.
All right. Amy, good to have you here. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you. Good to be here.